Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi all. Right now I'm gonna explain about histerotilasium and pseudocapillaria. But first, let me introduce our team. We were from group 4. Our team is Reta Dwinandira, Siska Adelia Sitompul, Korea Adenu Fasil, Mahdania Aulia Rahmah, Suliani, Kurnia Hulaki, Muhammad Slamet Mariadi. So, let's get it. Classification of Histerotilasium. Kingdom Animalia. Phylum Nematode. Class Chromadorea. Order Raptitida. Family Raptitidae. Genus Histerotilasium. Species Histerotilasium sp. Now we're into the morphology of Histerotilasium. Histerotilasium is a medium-sized worm, caudical annulated, anterior end with three equal size labia, length similar to width. Interlabia medium size, it's composed primarily of two hook-like protrusions and approximately half the length of labia. Dorsal labium with two lateral double papillae. Subventral labia, each with double and single papillae. Aphids, not located. There is esophagus, ventricular appendix, and sensum, lateral alae, and nerve ring. Right now, I'm gonna ask you first, what is the difference between male and female of Histerotilasium? So the difference is the male body 12 mm long, maximum width 0.69 mm at second third of body, head 130 long, 155 wet at base, length of esophagus 1.40 mm representing 11.7% of body length, nerve ring and excretory port 310 and 610 from base of head respectively, ventricular appendix 800 long, sesum 620 long, tail length 110, tail tip lagging spines and protuberance, 10 pairs of precloacal caudal papillae, no 8 cloacal or postcloacal papillae located. Face mid not seen. The female body is 11.7 mm long, maximum width 0.85 mm at second third of body, head 165 long, length of esophagus 1.29 mm, representing 12.9 of body length, nerve ring and excretory port 280 and 400 from base head, respectively. Ventricular appendix 920 long, sesum 580, tail length 245, tail tip cylindrical with no spines or protuberance, vulva position at 22.4 of body length from anterior end, uterus 4.3 mm long, 899 long and 93 wide. Now, the life cycle of Histerotilasium. This is the picture what explain the life cycle of Histerotilasium. A. Egg with the infected third stage larva. B. First intermediate host. C. Second intermediate or transport host. The prenzel could be first intermediate host, transport host, or paratenic if their flesh is not eaten by the salmonid. D. Definitive host, the balanoid fish could be paratenic or definitive host. The non-crustacean invertebrates, the polychaetes and the fishes could act as obligate intermediate or transport host when the size of the larva is too small due to the limited space of their copepod first intermediate host. These larvae are unable to infect directly a fish that is a definitive host and need a non-crustacean intermediate host. When amphipods are the first intermediate host, the larvae that could grow bigger would be transmitted directly to the fish. Now, host and predilection of Histerotilacium, host, marine fish, especially salmon. The predilection is in the heart, eyes, and the muscle of fish that occurs to the migration of parasite larvae. Right now, we are going to explain you about pseudocapillaria. But first, let me explain this classification of pseudocapillaria. Kingdom Animalia, Division Nematodes, Class Enoplea, Ordo Enoplida, Family Capillaridae, Genus Capillaria, Species Pseudocapillaria sp. This is the picture of body structure of pseudocapillaria. A. Anterior end of female. B. Sepalic end. C. Schistocytes at the middle part of schistosome. D. Region of vulva, lateral view. E. Posterior end of male, lateral view. F. Caudal end female, lateral view. G and X, proximal and distal ends of spicule, respectively. I, caudal end of male with extruded spicular seed lateral view. G, egg. G and L, caudal end of male, lateral and ventral views. M and N, same higher magnificent. Morphology of pseudocapillaria. Pseudocapillaria is a small filiform nematodes, anterior end of body narrow, rounded, sepalic papillae indistinct. Two lateral bacillary bands extending along almost whole body length, muscular esophagus long, narrow. Schistosome consisting of single row, about 35 until 38 elongated stichocyte, subdividly usually into many transverse annuli, nuclei of schistocytes large, nerve ring encircling muscular esophagus at about its one-third, two wing-like cells present at esophagus intestinal junction. This is the picture of pseudocapillaria life cycle. A. Pseudocapillaria larvae. B. The assumed life cycle of pseudocapillaria transmission through the food web and less likely or hypothetical transmission. This is the first life cycle of a marine species of a pseudocapillaria nematode to be described. None of its life stage has previously been recognized. Since the larvae eggs were infective to goldfish as well as to oligochaetes and cirrhonomid larvae, the invertebrates must act as transport hosts. Goldfish act as obligatory intermediate hosts. Debs and probably other fish intermediate hosts may possibly acquire the infection via infected goby. This constitutes the first record of an insect larva in a pseudocapillaria life cycle. Since many pseudocapillaria are terrestrial and learning, it is believed that insect larvae may play an important role, especially in freshwater pseudocapillaria life cycle. Small pseudocapillaria larvae are very difficult to detect and may be found only after careful searching. Host and predilection. Type host is ornate jellyfish. The predilection is on the digestive tract. And the other host is shark sucker. And the predilection is in the intestine. So this is the reference that we used to. Thank you for watching and see you tomorrow. Bye bye.